Good morning, welcome back to Breakfast Television, Porter 7. Thanks for making us part of your day. Coming up Friday at Porter's Place Mall, they're going to host a special safety expo. And here with what you can expect, we got Sergeant Ben Hagman from the Winnipeg Police Service, from Hockey Winnipeg, Monty Miller. Monty, we'll talk hockey and safety in a minute because that's always a big deal for us. But Sergeant, I want to talk with you about what people can expect when they head down and see the police services, because you guys are offering tons of cool things.
Yeah, you know what? First of all, thank you for having us.
Pleasure.
On Friday, October 24th, during regular business hours at Portage Place Mall, what you can expect from us with the first annual Safety Expo is this. We have brought together a collection of safety experts, different organizations through the city who are bringing to the table a different safety message for the citizens of Winnipeg. So people can come down to the mall and they should be able to expect to walk away with information from across the safety spectrum. So it might be specific to the workplace,
sure.
It can be specific to home. We have some information you'll hear about shortly, specific to sport. Through the course of the day, we'll also be offering some safety demonstrations. We will have our Winnipeg Police Service K-9 unit there providing some demonstrations for the public.
We're going to have... Monty, I don't know if you've ever seen them, but it is amazing to watch these dogs and their handlers work. It
certainly is.
That alone is worth the price of admission.
Highly trained professionals. We're going to have a bomb unit demonstration there, and the Winnipeg Fire Paramedic Service will be doing some rappelling with their high-angle rescue unit from the third floor of Portage Place Mall down to the main floor. So some very exciting things happening. In addition to that, I should mention that there'll be some presentations up in the theaters where you can come in, sit in the theaters, and hear presentations from various safety experts on just those topics I mentioned a moment ago. So a very exciting day, and I encourage everyone in the city to come down and join us. And we are working together to create that culture of safety that the chief of police talks about here in the city of Winnipeg.
And it's great to see everybody coming together in one place, because we quite often see a car safety thing here or a Mothers Against Drunk Driving here. It's great to see everyone together, working together, including, Monty, Hockey Winnipeg. I want to talk a little bit about respect in sport. We saw some issues in the past. We have a new initiative. How do we expect respect in sport to make a difference when it comes to safety in our city?
Well, the respect in sport program is an educational program, of course, for the parents. Sort of just to teach you how to sort of relate to your child, how to cheer properly for them, how to interact with other parents, interact with other coaches, how to basically sort of behave yourself in the stands, right? So that's kind of our angle with this, is it's just, when the community services of the police service approached us, we thought, well, that'd be perfect. It's another component for us to get involved with them on the respect side, on the safety side. We've got our respectful hockey policy, we've got our social media policy, we've got our now our respect and support for parent, and then we're working with another program that you'll hear about on Friday with the Winnipeg Police Service. So it's just, we thought getting involved with the guys and being at the expo was a good thing. We also have some concussion testing baseline stuff that we're working with the Pan Am concussion folks with.
Because it's all about knowledge information, as we were talking earlier, and I was saying, it's not we have bad fans in the stands, we got people who need a reminder, people who need a little bit of info. And that's what this day is all about. You'll find all the links on breakfasttelevision.ca, so you can find information on all those groups and all those events, including the times as we go from 10 to 7 at Polo Park. Going to take a break, there's plenty still to come today on PT. Thanks, guys. Thank you. Great. 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 Great.